I was in college, one of my kids with my mother.
Well, they came to
my mother. I said, I don't think that the women here in my family, I'm talking about my sisters, are respecting me. And I said to her, I think that you're the leader, and they just follow you, take your lead. And she said to me in an honest way that the reason why
she
treated me the way she treated me, because I reminded her of
my father.
And I thought to myself, this is pretty evil. That is a pretty fucked up thing
to do and to, you know.
So basically, you're taking out hatred just for being a man. When I went to college, one of the things I noticed when I went to a black college, that all the women resembled my sisters in the way they behaved and the way they treated men. And I could see that it was the same. One of my friends in college, he went to Cuba. He explained to me how the women were different there in Cuba, and how his interaction. And I remember that sticking with me, and I wanted to go to Cuba. So in my preparations to go to Cuba right after college, my uncle called me. He said, you know you can't go to Cuba? He said, if you want to go somewhere, go to the Dominican Republic. So, and there was no direct flight to Cuba anyway from the United States. So what I did was, I went to the Dominican Republic. I took heed to what he was saying. I went to the Dominican Republic, even though I didn't know anything about the Dominican Republic. I looked on the map to see where it was. It was right next to Cuba. The only thing I knew about the Dominican Republic was this map. And I knew of some Dominican people when I grew up in New York and in Boston. There was some Dominican people that I knew of. But I didn't know anything about the Dominican Republic. Any news? So on my way there, I remember looking out the window, being over the ocean. I've been thinking, man, we're going too far, man. We're gonna
fall off the world.
Like, the anxiety was really, you know, going to a place I don't know.
I have no expectations of.
You know, I was, like, I didn't even know one person that went to the Dominican Republic. It's not like today where, you know, everybody going to the Dominican Republic. It was my first, I didn't know anybody, you know. So when we landed, I remember seeing a crowd of people, and basically the Dominicans, they're very family oriented. So when their family comes from the States, they have a big party, and the party starts at the airport. You see crowds of people, like rushing the lines of people getting off the planes. And what this did was scare me, because I'm thinking they want to eat me. You know, that was the first thing that came out. These people, they want to eat me. I remember thinking, I want to, you know, hold up. Like, I wanted to rush back on the plane. Be like, no, I changed my mind.
I don't want to come here.
So, when I got to the airport, the taxi people, they were like rushing me and asking me, come on to my taxi, come on. And being very extra aggressive. I remember going to one taxi.
I feel like he overcharged me. He did overcharge me. He charged me like $35 or $40. To go
to a 10-minute ride to this place called Boca Chica. I didn't know what it was, but he just dropped me off there. Because I told him, just take me to a
hotel, so I don't know nothing about this country. And he dropped me at Boca Chica, which was the Sosua of Boca Chica at the time. But I didn't know. I had no expectation what to expect.
I didn't even go for the girls, because I didn't know anything about girls. So got there, the first thing he dropped when I got into my hotel,
first thing I went
was to the beach, because it was right off, the beach was right there. And so I went to the beach, and then I prayed.
Because I wanted to thank God that I made it safe, you know.
So I prayed, and maybe 10,
15 minutes later, there was some secret police came and they arrested me. I guess they saw me praying and they didn't understand why.
If you like this, what I had to say,
and you want me to continue,
you know, subscribe.
And
you know, I continue the story.